We are going ahead with the ratio chapter, ratio and proportion. So what is proportion? Proportion is when we have a pair of ratios and they are equal. So proportion is equality of two ratios. Okay. So far we have been dealing with two numbers. Actually, you have done a little bit of proportion in the previous exercise, the last two questions that we will come to later. So for now, you understand this, that proportion is equality of two ratios. So if we are taking two pairs of ratios and if there is some sort of equality between them both, then it is called proportion. So here I've already put up an example. Say for example, say there is 150 liters of water and here there is 100 liters of water. So this is the volume of water and this is the weight. So if there is 150 liters of say water, it weighs 135 kgs. So this is the weight of 150 liters of water. And say for example, this is the weight of 100 liters of water. So how do I know that these are in proportion? So first of all, forget about the proportion thing. All these four numbers that we talk about in a proportion, they are called as terms. Even in ratio, the two numbers that we spoke about, they were called terms. And in ratio, we didn't have this. We had only two terms. So if there were two terms, there was a certain name for this and there was a certain name for this. This was called antecedent and this is called the consequent. Okay. Similarly, in proportion, we don't have four separate names, but the terms at the extreme end, they are called extremes, okay, or they are called extreme terms. So simply you can call them extremes or you can call them extreme terms. And the terms which are inside, means the second and the third term, they are called means or middle terms. Okay, middle terms or means. So that is regarding the names. These two are called extremes and these both are called means. That is regarding the names. Now we go back to our question. Now how will I know that these two ratios are inequality? Okay, to be in equality means to be in proportion. So how do we check that? What we have to do is we reduce the ratio like we have been reducing earlier. So I can write this as a fraction, 150 upon 100, and this also I write as a fraction, 135 upon 90. Now I know that both of these are divisible by 10. Okay? So 10 divides this 15 times and 10 divides this 10 times. You can further reduce it. Both are again divisible by 5. 5 divides this 3 times and this 2 times. It cannot be reduced further. So the ratio that we got is 3 is to 2. Now let us do the same with this. Reduce both of them. Both are divisible by 5. 5 divides this how many times? 5 divides 9 once. 40 will be left. 8s are 40. Isn't it? Then 5 divides 13 2 times. 3 will be left. 7. Now both of these are divisible by 9. 9 divides 18 2 times. And 27 3 times. So you got 3 upon 2, which is 3 is to 2. So we can see that this pair of ratios is in equality because you want identical ratios on both the sides. So they are in proportion. So this is one way of finding out whether ratios are in proportion or not. So this is one of the type of questions that you'll have to solve. So what do? You simply write the ratios as a fraction, reduce it, and if you're getting the same on both the sides, means they are in proportion. And the other method is, there is a formula states that the product of the extremes is equal to the product of the means we find the product of the extremes. We already learned that this and this and these two numbers are called extremes. So to find the product means we need to multiply that. So 150 multiplied by 90 is equal to product of the means, and the means are 100 into 135. When you multiply both of these, they need to be equal. So say 150 into 90. So you simply multiply 15 into 9. 15 9s are 135. 135 and the two zeros. And here also it will be 135 and the two zeros. So to find out whether two ratios are in proportion or are in equality, there are two methods. One is this method wherein you reduce and check, and the other method is this. You find out the product of the extremes and you find out the product of the means. If both of them are equal, then they are in proportion.